Now that you've had some practice with vendor transactions, we will talk about finding and fixing the most challenging mistake to manage, a misapplied payment. The normal procedure in business to make sure that our records match the vendor's is that the vendor sends us a monthly statement that includes all transactions. The statement should have both a summary of the results of the remaining unpaid bills, as well as a detail of every single transaction that we had with the vendor during that month, or during the month of time that the statement is showing. Once we get the statement, we must compare it to our records, and if there's any difference, we have to tell the vendor. We focus on the mistake of a misapplied payment because any other mistake will be clear for your eyes to see. When you compare the vendor's monthly statement to our records and the vendor reports that we learned about, it will be very easy for you to see if either we or they have a duplicate transaction. It will be very easy for us to see if either we or they are missing a transaction. It will be clear if either of us entered the wrong money amount. And of course, if any of us entered the wrong date, the transactions will be in a different order and listed in a different position on the page. Some of the symptoms or clues that you have a misapplied payment will be that you agree with the monthly statement and the total balance that the vendor is showing you. However, the individual amounts of the unpaid bills are different. This is evidence that somewhere either we or the vendor misapplied one of the payments that were sent. Remember, a misapplied payment is more likely in a situation where bills are not paid in date order. Let's take a look at our unpaid bills section for Con Edison. This is the way the unpaid bills detail should look in your file after the last exercise set, focusing only on Con Edison. We have three bills for $1,000 each, and the total is $3,000. However, if you had misapplied one of the payments in the exercise, your unpaid bills for Con Edison might look like this. Now notice, the total balance for Con Edison is correct. However, it's clear to see that the individual bills one by one, or the remaining amount of the unpaid bills for each one, are not correct. This is a clear indication that there is a misapplied payment. Now, what do we do to find and fix this? Well, obviously we have to find the payment and reapply it. In order to do that, we should open up the vendor balance detail. The vendor balance detail lists every bill and every payment. We should open up each payment to see how it is applied. Once we find the misapplied payment, we can reapply it and make it correct. In a real situation, you might have to be on the phone with the vendor while you do this to make sure that all of your payments are applied in the way that you agree. Let's take a look. Here we are in the QuickBooks file, and you can see the section of Con Edison is wrong. The total $3,000 is correct, but the individual bill amounts are still wrong. The only way to fix a misapplied payment is to open this report, the vendor balance detail, where you can see all of the bills and all of the payments. It is very likely that this is the payment that's misapplied because the difference was $990. Let's double click. Now you can see here that when you reopen a bill payment, this is the way the window looks after you have saved it and reopened it. The top part looks like the check, and the bottom part tells you where the payment has been applied. You have to be very careful when you reapply payments. First, you have to remove the check mark, and that'll make the money amount up top disappear. you do not replace the check onto the other bill. If you do that, QuickBooks will assume you're paying the whole bill and change the money amount of the check. You have to be very careful. Remove the check marks completely, but don't recheck the margin. Instead, move to the right side and physically type in the amount paid. Then when you push the tab key, the correct amount of the payment will be applied to the correct bill. This is a very tricky and temperamental window. You might have to practice this. But when we click Save and Close, you notice we can come back to the unpaid bill report, and the section of Con Edison now shows that the individual bills are $1,000 each, which is the correct result that we want.